Hey, it's SGU, and welcome to another episode of SGU Sports Take, where we take on real-life sports discussion topics. And today we have quite a sports talker in the way of Game 7 of the World Series. But before we get to that, which will be the main part of this SGU Sports Take episode, I want to talk about something going on with my hometown NFL squad. They started off 5-0 this season and now have sputtered to a 5-2 record coming out of the bye week. That is the Minnesota Vikings. And today, shocking news coming from the club that offensive coordinator Norv Turner has decided to resign immediately. Now, yes, the team has struggled mightily in the last 2 weeks, specifically with the offense. And yes, that reflects a little bit on Norv Turner. But no one really was expecting a move like this. And the Vikings are swearing that it is not something that was being forced on Norv Turner, that this was being done for personal reasons, that he decided it was time to resign and step down from offensive coordinator position. That leaves Pat Shurmur as the interim offensive coordinator. He's worked with Sam Bradford in the past, and they're comfortable with each other, but that's not going to fix the Vikings' offensive line woes and the injuries. That is the big story. Speaking of injuries, Coach Zimmer had one of his own. He had to miss his press conference yesterday because he was found to have a detached retina and had to have surgery on that. So back to work today, and he comes in to a bombshell that his offensive coordinator is resigning. So what is going on with the Minnesota Vikings? It seems to be quite the tailspin here after the bye. They go into the bye 5-0. They come out and lay two clunkers down thanks to mostly their offensive line looking just terrible. Now, obviously, this team has had a lot of injuries to overcome. Adrian Peterson, and it just started there, going down on the line and decimating their offensive line at key positions, left tackle being one of them. And you see Jake Long coming in and not helping whatsoever, just a turnstile, and showing why he's been a free agent all this time. Many of my viewers on social media and through the YouTube comments have said, oh, how do you feel about those 5-0 Vikings when they started off? And I said, well, you know what? I've seen way too much Viking football over the year to be cautiously optimistic, because I've seen a lot of these starts turn 180 degrees and fizzle out to the point where we back into the playoffs or miss them all together. And it usually is just some kind of strange reversal like we're seeing now, whether it's injuries or just a mindset in the team. I don't know, but I'm really hoping that they can turn things around. I don't know if they're going to be able to. That offense just looks all out of sorts, and I don't know if a change at the offensive coordinator is going to make a difference. You guys think so? Let me know in the comment section below. But we are moving on to our main topic of the day now, and it's the main topic in all of sports. How could it not be? World Series Game 7 tonight. Chicago Cubs force Game 7 with a convincing Game 6 win, 9-3, as that man right there, Addison Russell, grand slam and 6 RBI total. I believe that tied a World Series record, and they poured it on to send this to a deciding winner-take-all Game 7 tonight in Cleveland. It'll be Corey Kluber against Kyle Hendricks. Some are making a case that this could be the single most important game in baseball history, and it's kind of hard to argue with that thinking, because you have two legendary franchises here with very, very long droughts with championships. You have fan bases that have been waiting a very, very long time for this moment to come, and only one dream is going to be realized tonight. Is it going to be the Cubs, or is it going to be the Indians? Someone is going to feel the highest high possible here and end their futility, while the other once again is going to have to say, oh, well, wait till next year. And that is a hard pill to swallow when you get this close. Now, the Cleveland Indians were in Game 7 in 1997 and lost that World Series oh so close. But no, they could not get it done. They find themselves in that same position again tonight. Can it be a different story for them with their crowd behind them? But I think most importantly, Corey Kluber on the mound, who has been outstanding, not only in this World Series, but in his home starts this season, absolutely dominating. So the Cubs have to find a way to get through him. And if they do, then they have to deal with Andrew Miller in that bullpen, who could come in as early as the fourth, fifth inning, whatever they need. It's all hands on deck tonight for both teams. You'll not be surprised to see starters in there. You'll see whatever they need to throw here, because there is no tomorrow. only this winner-take-all Game 7, and it's never been higher stakes than this for two franchises, starving for a championship. Cleveland as a city already got a taste this year when the Cleveland Cavaliers were able to come back from a 3-1 deficit and beat the Golden State Warriors to take the NBA championship. Now, are the tables going to be turned? Are they going to see one of their beloved franchises lose a 3-1 lead in a series to lose a championship? Well, we're getting ahead of ourselves. Obviously, they have a very real chance to finish this off and avoid that and win it tonight. But it's got to be in their minds. These Cubs have been the best team in baseball all season, best record in baseball. Of course, home field advantage for tonight's deciding Game 7 decided by, well, none other than the All-Star Game. That's a whole nother topic for debate on whether that should be what decides a World Series home advantage, but that is what is exactly happened here and played out, and it is in the Indians' favor. Now, they couldn't finish it out last night in Game 6 in front of their home crowd, but they get another chance tonight. It's going to be absolutely crazy, not only in Cleveland, but also back in Chicago, where people were lining up this morning to get into the Wrigleyville bars and get a good spot for tonight's potentially historic, well, it will be historic, potentially historic for the Cubs, that is, if they are able to win it and they want to be there to celebrate. People flying into Chicago to be a part of that potential celebration. So, what will we see tonight? Who do you think takes home the World Series trophy? Will it be the Chicago Cubs coming back from a 3-1 deficit all the way back to take the championship when it seems so unlikely, when they almost got swept out of Wrigley Field? They got that Game 5 win, hung on for Game 6, then throttled the Indians in Game 6. So now, where does the momentum lie? Who has the upper hand going into tonight? We know who has home field advantage, but which team has that psychological advantage? Which team holds the momentum, which is oh so important here, and which Chicago club lineup hits the field tonight? It's going to be the one that's been shut out, what, five times in this postseason, including by this man, Corey Kluber? Or is it going to be the team that belted out 9 runs last night? Have they awoken? We started off back at the division series with me making some baseball playoff predictions. Now, I got most of the series right. The only thing I did not get right was the Dodgers series. I saw the Nationals winning that one. It was not the case. But I did predict Indians and Cubs in the World Series. And what did I say the finish would be? Too late to change now, right? Let's go roll the tape and see what my thoughts were back then.
I don't know. I think in my mind that the Cubs are actually going to break this curse. I think the Cubs are going to get it done. Theo Epstein has that confidence that he's assembled the right bunch. This is a great team. They've been a great team all along. The pitching's been there. The power bats. Hey, they were a star-studded all-star lineup. And through and through, this team's been great. I think they handle the pressure. They say what curse? They get it done, just like the Red Sox did in 2004 with Theo Epstein at the helm. Chicago Cubs, World Series champs. I'm going out on a limb, and that's what I'm predicting.
Okay, there it was. That's what I predicted back when the division series were starting, and here we are tonight, a Game 7 winner take all. My prediction still very much intact, can come true, and no reason to change it now. I will take the Cubs in a Game 7 win and a series comeback. Now, what do you guys think? What happens tonight? Is Corey Kluber too much for this Cubs offense? Once again, does he shut them down and get the Indians a trophy? Or do the Cubs continue the momentum from the last couple games and finish this off in improbable fashion and break that curse? Let me know in the comment section below what you think is going to happen. This should be a great friendly debate. Yeah, I said friendly. Let's keep it friendly here because we are about to witness one of the biggest Major League Baseball season finales, certainly of my lifetime, if not of all time. So let me know your predictions for tonight's World Series Game 7. And what are you going to do? You're going to watch it at home? You go into the bar to check it out? You're going to gather with friends? Let me know how you are going to spend this truly historic night for baseball. All right, guys, thanks for joining me for another SGU Sports Take. As always, if you have ideas for topics to be covered in a upcoming video, let me know. I always like to have the suggestions, and maybe we can get to your ideas. So let me know in the comment section below ideas for real sports discussion here on SGU Sports Take. Again, thanks for joining me, and enjoy that World Series Game 7 tonight. It's going to be a classic. We'll see you next time.